Hello. I've been with the business now for the last 9 months. I've met with clients, with partners, with internal teams, and worked extensively with the management team on a strategic review of Ebiquity's business and business opportunities going forward. I'm here today to present you an accelerated growth plan for the business. We'll be talking about 5 specific topics that we'll walk you through in this presentation to go in detail about giving you a background on the strategic ambition for the business and some context, providing an overview of our business, then going deeper into an accelerated organic growth plan for the MPO business, talk a little bit about what sort of organization we're trying to build to support their growth plan, and then summarizing everything at the end in an investment case and key milestones. Let's get started with a little bit of business background and our strategic ambition. We have the opportunity as Ebiquity to become the leading independent technology-enabled media analytics and marketing analytics company worldwide. There's a real opportunity in the marketplace at this point in time. We have increasing client demand for independent and objective advice in marketing. And that's not just related to transparency of agencies, but also transparency of their trading partners overall. It's really rare to get objective and independent advice, and our senior clients are looking for that. To get there, we will have to make progress in 4 areas. One of the 4 areas is we have to swim more upstream, have more strategic relationships at the board level with our senior clients. Those are the people who are making the big investment decisions about media and marketing spend. And we have an opportunity to become their strategic and independent advisors for all questions related to media and marketing spend. Some of those relationships we already have, and some of those we need to build over time. Second, our services and products increasingly need to be industry standards. We have some methodologies who are already doing that. If you think, for example, in our MVM practice, we have ValueTrack as clearly the established methodology for media auditing and benchmarking. We need to have more of that going forward. When we then look at our products, some of those products that we currently have need to be more technology-enabled, self-service and web-based. And we are working hard to accomplish that already, and we'll see more of that. And lastly, our thought leadership needs to be well recognized by our clients, by the media, and the industry overall. We have some of that already happening. Our most recent example, the work that we did with the ANA, is a good example of that, and we'll see more of that in the future. So there is a real opportunity to become an independent strategic advisor as it relates to the marketing and media landscape for senior executives. Let's look a little bit about what we do today and our current practices. Currently, we go to market with 3 practice areas: MPO, MVM, and MI. So briefly describing those practices, in MPO, we really help our clients allocate their marketing spend between the different media and marketing tactics. And we help them optimize their marketing spend, and we help to optimize consumer journeys, in particular when it comes to digital channels. In MVM, we help our clients select their trading partners, look at media transparency, identify performance of selected media channels, and make sure that their trading partners comply with contractual terms. And in our MI practice, we have a portfolio platform that helps our clients analyze their creative, their competitors' creative, the media spend associated with, and develop new creative strategies. Now, we're trying to evolve Ebiquity in the next couple of years into a technology-enabled consultancy. If we look at the business today, outside of our MI practice, where we have a core product, we have very limited use of technology in the business. Going forward, we want to make sure that Ebiquity is truly technology-enabled and that technology is embedded into all of our service offerings that we offer for our clients. Unlike other consultancies, it is really critical for us to be technology-enabled, and that's because of the nature of the media and marketing space we're operating in. To give you a few examples on a very high level, if you think, for example, about our MPO practice, it used to be the case that in the past, we would receive from clients a few thousand rows of data to analyze and tell them and help them decide where to spend their marketing budget. Nowadays, we're getting billions of rows of data, and we can use traditional methodologies to quickly turn around insights. So we need to use technologies to better process and analyze that data. The same is true for our MVM practice. Channel fragmentation, increased use of digital channels, have created a vast amount of data that our clients want to look at to make investment decisions and decide which channels are performing well and which are not. And therefore, we need to invest in technology to make sure we can ultimately enable them to make near real-time decisions as it relates to marketing budget allocation. And in our third practice, MI, we're already operating with a technology product. So for us, unlike other consulting companies who are purely based on people, we need an element of technology to enable us to be different and do the services we do so well today. Over the past few years, a lot of key foundations have been put in place to enable us to move forward very successfully. What has been put in place is a global network. For the first time, most of our acquisitions that we made are now out of earnouts. That means for the first time we can operate as one global company and bring our services to our global clients. We have a very strong brand as it relates to the MVM practice in particular. In many of our markets, we are universally recognized as the leader in media auditing and benchmarking. We have very strong talent and methodologies that helped us grow the MPO practice in multiple countries. And we have established entry points to 80% of the top 100 advertisers worldwide. So we have relationships that we can leverage. We are working with these clients from which we can build on. And lastly, what has been done very well, the business has recognized the important growth opportunities in the MPO space. Now let's look at that growth a little bit. If you look at the last few reporting periods, we can see that MVM and MPO have really been driving our growth. They have been growing between 15 and 20% the last couple of reporting periods. Therefore, we will focus on five areas going forward. Organic expansion of our MPO practice to make the service offering more broadly available. Deepening and expanding the relationships that we already have with some of our big clients. Developing and further developing our digital service offering. Further productizing some of the tools and methodologies that we already have in place. We have products and tools in place, and we need to now make sure they are more scalable and putting them more into products. And lastly, creating an organization that can support our global ambition, but also our ambition to become a technology-enabled services consultancy. To unlock that growth, we need to adjust our current operating margins. If we compare ourselves to comparable firms, who are also people-based businesses, our margin of about 16.4% over the last three reporting periods is significantly higher than comparable businesses. Those businesses are run very successfully, but they are run at between 10 and 11% operating margins. Now, we believe with being technology-enabled, we can have a premium margin, and our mid to long-term margin target is between 12 to 13%. As a result of these opportunities and investments into growth, we believe we're going to build a higher quality, more robust, and more global business. We are aiming at a revenue CAGR of 10% from 2016 to 2021. MVM and MPO, our key growth areas, will then make up over 80% of our revenues by 2021. We will have a more geographically diversified revenue base, so we'll be operating in more country and bigger weight of some of the countries that we're working in, and we'll move to a mid-term operating profit margin of between 12 to 13% by 2018. And now I would like to talk a little bit about more about how the business looks like at the moment and provide you a little bit of a business overview. I talked about the three service areas of our business, and I would like to expand more a little bit how the structure of those service areas look like. So we have three distinct service areas, and we have methodologies, services, and products in each of those three. But they have various degrees between what the services are and what the products are. In that sense, our MPO and MVM practice are very similar. It's a people-based business that over time will make more technology-enabled, and the share between services and technology-enabled services and products is about 95% services and 5% products. That's different to our MI practice, where we are pretty much basically a product business, where over 85% of our revenues are product-based. As an organization, we are increasingly becoming digital. If you look at 2011 revenues, we had a share of about 2% digital, probably even below that. If you look at 2016 revenues, we're going to be about 15% digital. And going forward, I think you will see an accelerated growth of our digital proportion as it relates to the total business. Given our recent initiatives and upcoming launches, we expect that our MVM practice will continue on the growth trajectory that we have seen in the past. There's a couple of things that are coming up that I want to highlight in particular. One of the things that you're all familiar with, we have been working very closely with the Association of National Advertisers in the US on the questions around media transparency. This is an ongoing debate, and to be clear, this debate is not just limited to agencies, it's extending to the trading partners more generally. There is a real need and demand from our clients around more transparency in media in general. So we'll be continuing to do our work in that space. The second thing we're doing is we have realized over the last many months that there are increasing questions around more strategic areas in media. So for example, questions around programmatic, questions around advertising technology and media technology and the use of those technologies, which of those services to bring in-house, where to use partners, and we are uniquely positioned with our expertise, credibility, and experience to bring those services to our clients. We'll be launching this practice in the not-too-distant future. We have also appointed, on a global basis, MVM practice leaders. So we are moving away from a local country-by-country structure into a global operating structure as it relates to our methodologies, processes, and products. So for the first time, we will be able to provide unified, standardized services across multiple countries, while at the same time being extremely relevant locally. As it relates to products and methodologies, I want to highlight two things we're doing in the MVM practice. One, we kicked off the development of a paid media performance measurement platform. This development has started and we'll bring that to market. And the second area I want to highlight is a methodology that will help us increase the ability to manage and orchestrate data. And this product will help us internally to make that process a lot more efficient. The project is called Connect, and we'll be launching it before the end of the year. Within the MI practice, we are making our offering more competitive. Let me give you three examples for that. One, we very recently launched a new portfolio international platform where we are bringing together creative with media spend. We launched it in a couple of markets, and clients have been very receptive and very happy with what they have seen. Secondly, we are working on the launch of a digital offering for media and creative spend. This offering, we believe, is unique in the marketplace, and we are very excited of working on that offering and bringing that to market in the next couple of months. And thirdly, we have been working on improving internal efficiencies as it relates to data capture and processing, and we're making good progress to further improve our competitiveness based on that. Now, let's move on to going in depth about our organic MPO growth acceleration program. As I said up front, we really see the biggest opportunity for growth for us to come from the MPO practice. Our MPO offering basically comprises two services. We have marketing effectiveness and multi-channel analytics. When we talk about marketing effectiveness, what we're essentially talking about is statistical analysis to analyze marketing data to make better channel choices. So we're helping our clients decide where to invest their marketing dollars as it relates to whatever marketing objectives they have, for example, increasing sales. If we look at multi-channel analytics, this is a service offering where we're helping our clients improve conversion rates, in particular as it relates to consumer journeys in digital channels. So we're helping reduce friction, thereby increasing whatever marketing goals a client has with digital channels. Over the last 3 years, we have seen our MPO services grow very quickly. So we saw like-for-like revenue growth on a CAGR basis of about 40%. And both our revenues, but also our headcount, have significantly increased, and now we have a very solid offering in place. At the same time, we did a research study with the CMO Council to analyze what are the key challenges that senior marketing executives are facing when it comes to marketing and being an effective marketer. And when we look at the top challenges, we see that our existing MPO service offering are already addressing many of those top challenges. And therefore, we really see opportunity for continuous growth within our MPO service offering. When we look globally, across our three practice areas, we operate in 14 countries. However, if we then look at where we offer our MPO services, we are only currently offering the MPO services out of three of those markets. We are offering marketing effectiveness out of the UK and Spain, and we are offering multi-channel analytics out of the US marketplace. So we see great opportunity to expand that service offering into more markets. Therefore, we continue to see good demand for our MPO services, in particular because our clients are asking us to provide that service offering in more of our markets, and their clients we don't work with yet who have been contacting us, asking us if we can provide those services. So in summary, what we're doing in the MPO offering, I'll highlight a few areas. So we are planning to launch a marketing effectiveness practice in the US. We are planning to expand our marketing effectiveness service offering in selected markets in Western Europe and Asia Pacific. We are in the process and we will evaluate which offering and at what point in time the multi-channel analytics offering will be brought to market outside of the US and what the opportunity looks like, in particular in Europe. We are currently developing methodologies in our MPO practice. A good example of that is an attribution model, and we'll bring that attribution model to market in the next year. And we will invest further in productizing some of the methodologies and tools that we currently have in place. As a result of our MPO growth acceleration program and the continued growth of our MVM practice, the shape of our revenue base will change and we believe will become a higher quality business. So today, if you add up the MPO and MVM revenues, they make up about just over 70% of our revenue base. By 2021, we aim that number to be over 80%. Now let me talk a little bit what organization is required to support our growth ambitions and growth program going forward. There are primarily two drivers that require us to change to the way we operate at the moment. One is our clients. Our clients are increasingly asking us to provide the services that we do for them in one market in a more consistent way in another, or where we don't offer that service yet in another market, to start offering that service offering. And secondarily, we need to change the organizational setup from a country-by-country model into a global model to unleash that growth opportunity, but also to more effectively service our clients. Let me go into more detail about those focus areas underlying that. A clear set of actions is needed now. One, we need to become more client-focused. Therefore, we have recently appointed a chief client officer who will spearhead that effort and make sure we are considering and very focused on the client needs across geographies. Secondly, we have established clear practice leaderships to continuously evolve our service offering and making sure our service offering is competitive and relevant. We also need to be very clear where we flex between having globally standardized tools, methodologies, and products, and where we develop locally specific solutions. That's very important because our clients and the media landscape is very local. So we need to be very careful in the decisions about what services we offer on a local basis and what we standardize. We believe that our key comparative advantage lies within that balance because we can be more locally relevant, in particular when it comes to MVM, while at the same time providing global standards much better than our competitors can. We need to have clear accountability for both regional, local, and global initiatives. This is also the reason why we appointed practice leaders to lead our individual service offerings. And we need to enable our support functions to support that growth as we expand geographically and across our service offerings. I have outlined the opportunity ahead of us. We believe the time is now to grab that opportunity and grow organically. I'm not saying we're just doing MPO growth or growth organically, but the focus for now is organic growth. I've outlined an organizational structure that is required to support that growth. Let me now summarize some of those points, what it means as an investment case and milestones. From an investment case perspective, we are aiming to build a more robust, a more global, and a more higher quality business. We are aiming at long-term sustainable top line and profit growth. We will be cash flow generative and continuing our progressive dividend policy. Let me talk a little bit about the margin impact. Since we are investing in upcoming businesses organically, since we will be hiring talent in markets where we don't have a certain service offering, since we're building a support structure to enable that growth, that is an ongoing and continuous investment into us growing quicker than we have in the past. To summarize that, if you look at 2016 and key metrics, we have been growing, or we plan to grow, at about 7%. In 2021, we believe that's much closer to 10%. Our operating margin is around 17%. We believe, as I have outlined, the operating margin going forward on a sustainable level is between 12 and 13%. And our revenue mix will also change. Today we have around 70% of our revenue mix is MVM and MPO. Those are our high growing businesses, and that mix will be over 80% in 2021. We've worked very hard on a strategic review the last couple of months with the management team. We have gone into very detailed analysis about what is required and where we need to focus and where we need to invest and what milestones we need to hit over the next 5 years. We have outlined those in a plan, and we have associated timelines against those. I won't go into much detail in particular what those are individually, but the plan is in place and it will tie directly back to the key focus areas. To give you an example, the rollout of the effectiveness practice in the US, or the broader rollout of the effectiveness practice across Europe, or, for example, investments into methodologies and productization of our offering. In summary, we are seeing a great opportunity to become a leader in marketing and media analytics. So we want to become the independent, world-leading, technology-enabled media and marketing consultant going forward. There's an opportunity in the marketplace. Our clients are asking for independent advice, and nobody at the moment is offering that in an independent, unbiased way with the same level of specialist know-how as we have about media. We have a clear strategy for organic growth in place. We will operate at a more sustainable margin levels. We are working against a set of clearly defined milestones, and we are building a much higher quality business. I'm looking forward to share more about our products and services at the upcoming Capital Markets Day at the beginning of November. Thank you.